Hi everyone, welcome to Xinhua Live. I'm Yage with Xinhua News Agency. Now reporting from Zibo in East China's Shandong province. We are standing right now in the Sports Center, where the preliminary contests of Health Qigong of the 13th National Games of China are held. Today we're going to show you one of the oldest and most well-known styles of Qigong, which are just like working out nowadays. It is called 五禽戏 in Chinese, or in English, five animals play Qigong, a very Chinese way of keeping fit. So what is Qigong? Many of you may wonder about that, and many of you may regard Qigong as the privilege for Kung Fu masters. In fact, the age-old Qigong, which was always closely related to Chinese martial arts in the past, is also one of China's therapeutic exercises. Qigong, which is literally called life energy cultivation, is a holistic system of coordinated body posture and movement, breathing and meditation used for health, spirituality, and martial arts training. With roots in Chinese medicine, philosophy, and martial arts, Qigong is traditionally viewed as a practice to cultivate and balance qi, which means life energy. Qigong is now practiced throughout China and worldwide for recreation, exercise, and relaxation, preventive medicine and self-healing, alternative medicine, meditation, and self-cultivation, and training for martial arts. Till 2016, there have been altogether over 4 million people practicing health Qigong in China, and there are more than 2 million people practicing health Qigong abroad in 56 countries and regions. Qigong comprises a diverse set of practices that coordinate body, breath, and mind based on Chinese philosophy. There are numerous Qigong forms. It includes 75 ancient forms that can be found in ancient literature, and also 56 common or contemporary forms that have been described in the Qigong compendium. In 2003, the Chinese Health Qigong Association officially recognized four health Qigong forms, which are Muscle Tendon Change Classic, which in Chinese is called Yi Jin Jing, Five Animals Play, which in Chinese is called 五禽戏, Six Healing Sounds, which in Chinese is called 六字诀, and Eight Pieces of Brocade, which in Chinese is called 八段锦. The important news is Health Qigong will be the first time on stage at the National Games of China this year. So stay with us to find out more about the mysterious five animals play Qigong. And you are very welcome to leave questions, comments, and give us thumb ups. We will try to answer the questions as soon as we can. And now, as we're now watching the wonderful display of five animals play Qigong in this game, let me provide you with some more detailed information or historical backgrounds about 五禽戏, or what we call five animals play. 五禽戏, or the five animals play, can be regarded as the earliest form of medical Qigong in Chinese history, dating back to Eastern Han Dynasty. The creation of 五禽戏 was attributed to the famous Chinese physician and surgeon Hua Tuo, who had great skills as a surgeon, acupuncturist, herbalist, and scholar of human anatomy. He was the first to use anesthetics in scraping the poison from the arm of Quan Ti, the god of war and patron of the Qing dynasty. He is believed to be the first person in the world to have developed the use of anesthesia. Besides treating his patients when they were ill, Hua Tuo was also keen to recommend physical exercises for people as a method of rehabilitation, recovery, and most importantly, for prevention. 五行戏 is a set of deep stretching and deep breathing exercise. Imitates the actions of animals based on the habits of the tiger, deer, bear, ape, and bird. Although the profile and value of 五行戏 remained high through the history of China and Chinese population around the world, the lack of illustrated documents that survive the changes of China and indeed the world means that many different versions of 五行戏 are inevitable. Health Qigong 五行戏, one of Health Qigong series, is a new development with the support of Chinese Health Qigong Association to embody the essence of the traditional 五行戏 with balanced physical approach and bring good health and well-being for people living in the 21st century. It presents the scientific concept and the character of the modern time sufficiently and accords with the traditional principles of regulating the body, breath, and mind in Qigong. As a result, it fits the needs of people to promote their health. The routines of health Qigong 五行戏 are divided into tiger, deer, bear, ape, and bird place, each containing two movements. The routines begin and end with respectively preparative respiration regulation and qi returning movements, which is also known as live energy returning movements. Both the ranges and appearances of the movements are vivid embodiments of the fierceness and bravery of the tiger, serenity and leisure of the deer, composure and the steadiness of the bear, agility and cleverness of the ape, and the lightness and nimbleness of the bird, so that the entire set of routines presents a unity of both form and spirit, the combination of exercise and health preservation, the connection between thought and qi, and the integration of both the interior and the exterior. Practitioners of five animals play Qigong live long, healthy lives, in many cases up to 100 years or longer. They retain their teeth, hair, good skin color, and eyesight. There are many records of long living Qigong practitioners in China, dating back to thousands of years ago. Wise practitioners are often aware that beyond all physical extension and contraction of the movements, it is the internal impact of these movements that bring the healing benefit for a long term. Please stay tuned if you like our show. You can also share it with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Now we'd like to show you some videos here. And this is the Kung Fu world. There are so many powerful masters, and actually it is not so hard to learn and practice. The movements come spontaneously, and healing would occur naturally and quickly in most cases. Some people would even manifest hidden psychic abilities, such as healing with their own qi, or what we call life energy, seeing auras, being able to read other people's minds, distance healing, seeing through solid objects, being able to predict the future, and etc. It was found that some of these abilities could come quite quickly, within days or weeks for some exceptional practitioners, although such manifestations usually occur after months or years of practicing. And now, as we can see through our camera, the game is already on, and now it's two teams have finished their works, and they're waiting for the scoring. So, yes, and for this competition, there will be two teams competing with each other in every section. And Hua Tuo, let's continue with our historical background. Hua Tuo first experimented with the idea of the five animals play when he discovered that animals appear to possess a spontaneous self-healing capacity, which can be activated and systematically utilized through certain rituals and movements. The method has later been refined by succeeding Chinese doctors. During the five animals play, the practitioners not just imitate the movements of tiger, bear, deer, ape, and bird, but most significantly, they assume each animal's personality in turn. Indeed, from the phenomenological point of view, the practitioners become the personality they assume. And now, as we can see throughout camera, there are more teams going on to compete for the game. And now, perhaps our audience cannot see the screen, but I can tell you that till now, Chongqing province, the teams from Chongqing in southern China's city has been the number one, the winner till now, but still we have more teams going up, and you can follow our live now to find out more about this game and about this traditional Chinese culture. So, as more teams are competing on stage, I have a question. What is the benefit, or what are the benefits of five animals play, or what we call 五禽戏 in Chinese? Well, to be honest, I had never seen that before I came here, so I guess many of our viewers may have the same question as I did when I first heard of the term. So let's follow our camera to get a closer look of the gestures and movements of 五禽戏. Well, I'll give you the benefits that I was told from the compendium. Okay, so Hua Tuo discovered that the assumption has curative effects in accordance with the personality assumed. Tiger has the power to cure diseases related to lung or breathing system and the chest. The bear has the power to cure diseases related to kidney. Deer has the power to cure diseases related to liver. The bird has the power to cure the heart or blood circulation. And the ape has the power to cure the stomach. During the process, the practitioner's awareness of themselves psychologically and physically will be so heightened that if they properly let go, their fingers and hands will spontaneously manipulate the appropriate acupuncture points. They will also behave in the curative way, which is quite impressive. But here, a word of caution for everyone. It is strongly held that the five animals play must be studied only under the direct one-to-one personal instruction of a knowledgeable master. Wrong instruction may cause considerable psychic karma. To give more detailed information, five animals play Qigong consists of three steps. The first one is the opening ritual, which is to be done consciously. The second one is the semi-conscious part, which, as the name indicates, is to be done semi-consciously. And the last one is the closing ritual, which is to be done consciously. And today, as we follow our camera, we can see the preliminary contest of five animals play Qigong is going on right now. For the National Games of China this year, there are altogether 204 Qigong practitioners representing 34 teams across the country, participating and competing here in Zibo. The participants are aged between 18 and 65, so we can tell that five animals play Qigong is an exercise that almost anyone could learn. And this is really a good news for everyone, right? By the way, all the participants of the game, as we can see, are wearing traditional Chinese clothing in different colors, like purple, blue, red, and yellow, and etc. And there's so much embroidery on every piece of clothing, actually. As you can see, there are different shapes of flowers, and dragons, and etc. And these costumes under the light are really shining. Okay, we have a question from our dear audience. Are all this Kung Fu the ancient Chinese secret? Is that squirrel style? It's an ancient Chinese secret. I guess it is, because as I have mentioned before, this Wu Qin Xi, or Five Animals Play, is one of the ancient forms of Chinese martial arts. So I guess this is the original version, or the originator of other types of Qigong or other types of Chinese martial arts. But in order to answer the questions, we will talk about it later after we invite an expert to tell us more about the relationship between Chinese martial arts and Wu Qin Xi or Qigong. And now, as we can follow our camera, we can see on the right side of the stage, the team, and also the right and the left side, they are doing this kind of movements like a bird. And I guess this is one of the bird movements. It's like bird flying high up in the sky. And as we can see, this kind of game is going on like this. Two teams are on stage, and they're going to compete with the same series of movements. So they are doing the same kind of movements, but one ahead and one after the other. So the judges will try to judge the two teams, because that will be more fair, because they're doing the same movements, and it's more easy to compare with each other. And as there are a lot of expert practitioners here today competing, why don't we go and have a little chat with them? Hi, we are from China Xinhua News Agency, and we're doing live broadcasting on today's activity. So nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And could you please give us a brief introduction about yourself? What do you do often in your everyday life, and your name?
我叫李磊，我是中国科学院，在院机关工作，平时就从事科学研究的管理服务工作。我叫肖星星，来自中国科学院力学研究所，是科研工作人员，然后平时做飞行动力学方向的研究。
So they are from Chinese Academy of Sciences, and this one, this gentleman here is named Li Lei, and this lady here is named Xiao Xinxin, right? Xiao Xinxin, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and so actually their everyday life involves a lot with sciences, and actually with physics, and with aviation, and etc. So how long have you been practicing Wu Qin Xi, or Five Animals Play?
大概8点7分。气功练了大概不到10年，但是具体到五禽戏，也就只有组队以后练了有一个月。对，气功练了有将近10年。我气功练了接近8年，然后五禽戏也是练了一个月。
So actually, they're practicing Qigong. Qigong involves, as we have mentioned, a lot of types. And we can see it's Five Animals Play is only one of them. And this gentleman here has practiced this for almost 10 years. And this lady has practiced it for almost 8 years. So how did it come to you to start practicing Qigong?
其实最一开始是我们有这么一个协会。 中国科学院有一个武术协会，武术协会是常年开展太极拳和健身气功活动的。我们呢也是因为有这个协会才参与到这个活动中来，自己也是有 练了以后有一些切身的体会，所以才坚持下来。对。
So this gentleman told me that what made him start to practice Qigong is the first of all is that they have an organization actually.An organization in the Chinese Academy of Sciences, and apart from that, actually, as they are working day after night, they are very tired, and they found that Qigong is a very good way for their health. Can you tell us more about like how often would you practice every day nowadays?
每天的话。不太固定时间，然后因为气功它的练习场地和时间没什么具体的要求，所以说呢，有空的时候就伸筋拔骨练一练，然后周末的时候呢，大概会抽出半天的时间做集中的练习。
Okay, so this lady here told me that how often would she practice Qigong? For every day is about half an hour, but for weekends, like Saturday and Sundays, she will have half a day to practice Qigong. So sometimes when they are tired, they will try to practice Qigong to get a more healthy life. What about the stories? Do you have any difficulties when you first begin to practice Qigong? 就是刚开始
困难倒没有，没什么困难。小插曲。我们第一次在那个体协的组织下，去参加全国的全国体育大会，对，那是第一次去参加这种全国性质的大比赛，对，对，那也是刚学没多久，而且都是竞赛套路。竞赛套路的难度非常大，全是单腿支撑啊，对力量和柔韧的要求非常高，而且去的都是专业队，我们去了四个人，当然也都是相对比较年轻，对。对。
进行的，然后当时什么都不怕嘛，然后去了之后发现竞赛队的水平跟咱们普通群众练不一样，我们也硬着头皮上，但是非常有意义，也是从那次练习开始，然后我们就比较注重练习自己的基本的一些稳定性啊，然后力量型的一些练习，然后。
So I asked them about anything interesting going on when they first start practicing Qigong and also practicing Wu Qianxi. And as they are not really the professionals practicing it every day and every hour, so they find it very difficult at the first start when they do the competition with the global, with the other teams from across the country. They find it that some of the movements are really difficult, like the bird movements. They have to stand with 1 foot and they have to keep their balance. So this is a very interesting story, but after that experience, they are getting more and more experience and self-confidence, and also they are trying to practice it more often, and now their techniques are more mature. I have another question, is that where and how could the public learn Qigong or Wu Qianxi, in your opinion? 就是
大众，我觉得最广泛的还是那个健身气功的站点，以那个街道为单位的。对对对，我们是因为有协会，所以在协会主要开展这个活动。
站点的话，一般都有健身气功的指导员，然后健身气功的指导员的话，其实他们经过正规的培训，他应该是把比较正规的一些动作训练的要点告诉普通群众，最好是有人指点下进行练习。
Okay, so these two expert practitioners told me and advised to all of your audience watching our live that if you want to learn it, you better go to a professional station. Like we have a lot of stations, Qigong stations here in China, in every province, and almost in every street we have a station, and with a group of staffs and masters teaching Qigong. So you have to be professional and you have to learn it under proper guidance, or if you do not do that, then perhaps you will do it wrong and they may do harm to your body and mind. Okay, we have another question from our dear audience. Here, culture, not a question, but comment here, culture and history are the best in the world. Thank you very much. And also, do you have any other suggestions for our audience who want to learn or who are starting to learn Qigong?
希望大家能够循序渐进地练习气功，一开始呢可能是外形上的模仿，然后其次的话应该是就是去学习它里面的静力运行，然后呢除了动作的漂亮以外，还要注意本身动作运行对你人体经络或者你的关节的运动路线的一个调整和拉伸。然后最后呢，其实还是希望大家在学习到一定程度的时候呢，对中医的或者说是中国的传统的一些内涵，传统文化的内涵进行相关的一些了解之后，然后去更深入层次的了解为什么气功这么编，然后为什么这个动作要这么练，它真正对你起到作用的在什么地方，然后并且最重要一点是持之不懈的坚持练习，然后要跟大家互相交流，然后呢把动作的准确性和静力的准确性掌握好，这样就可以了。
Thank you very much. Our lady here told us a few advices. The first one is that you have to do it gradually. You can't just do it in one day. And also, our lady told us that before the first step is to mimic all the gestures, the movements of a bear, of deer, of ape, bird, and of tiger. But later, you have to get the essence of it. You have to learn the spirit as well, or also you have to learn about the Chinese traditional culture inherited in it. So thank you very much for your interview. Thank you.
10号队，谢谢分，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢
live broadcasting in Eastern China City, Zibo of Chinese Shandong province. And what we are living now are about Qigong, or especially kind of Qigong. It's called Wu Qin Xi, or Five Animals Play. And you are very welcome, and feel free to ask questions, and we will try to answer some of your questions. And please stay with us, because there will be more funny stuff going on and coming up. Okay, so actually I have to mention it again, because this is the first time for Five Animals Play Qigong to be competed on national level. And this is really, really impressive, and it's exciting. So since everyone could learn this exercise, perhaps I can give it a try, right? I always want to learn this because I find it very interesting to mimic all the gestures and movements of the animals. And let's go and take a look. And by the way, I'm very excited, and it is very exciting to be so close to the game, because you can see all the expert practitioners competing and their movements and also their costume. And I think costume is one of the, and also the music are the elements, the traditional elements also in this game. And this is part of the Chinese culture. For detailed information about Wu Qin Xi, or Five Animals Play, we have invited an expert here to tell us more. Or if you want to ask questions, you can ask it freely, because we will invite the expert to answer some of our questions. So our expert is called Master Yu Dingyuan. And Master Yu Dingyuan is actually the designer. Master Yu Dinghai. Oh, my memory. Master Yu Dinghai is actually the designer of the modern version of Health Qigong Wu Qin Xi, or Health Qigong Five Animals Play. And welcome.
你好。
So before asking you several questions, could you please show us one or two movements or gestures of Wu Qin Xi? Because I know that this kind of exercise is quite easy to learn, or not so easy to learn, but everyone could learn this kind of exercise, and so I want to have a try. So you can
teach me a few basic
moves. So our Master Yu has decided to teach us one or two movements, and our dear audience who are watching our live, please feel free to learn it and mimic it or imitate the movements with me and with our Master Yu.
好的，像你们记者平时很辛苦啊，
我教一个动作，你的接触的运动的动作。
嗯，好嘞。
也是五禽戏里面的动作。
So our master Yu said that journalists like I do, and also I think a lot of audience in front of the screen, you are always watching the computers, your mobile phones or iPad, and sometimes your neck hurts, right? So our dear master here decided to teach us one or two movements to help our neck to feel better.
五禽戏里面，虎戏里面有一个这个动作，这个是脊柱的蠕动。脊柱的蠕动，对，你这个脊柱弹放，对，给它转转，对，通过两个手把动作带起来，对吧？你们经常坐在这个地方，
对，
啊，能够给它活动起来，这个就是五禽戏里面的一个简单的原理，
就是虎
的。
So our master taught us one movement like this is to help your neck feel better because you always sit there and it's called one of the movements of tiger. It's like the tiger is grasping the prey and you have to move your whole body to get the gestures and we'll do it one more time.
我们再做一遍，让大家再跟着学一遍。
好的，两个手画立圆，然后带动身体，身体后仰。前俯，后仰，前俯，对，把这个肌肉活动开，像蠕动一样。
Yes, it's like a worm moving. And do you have any movements that you want to teach? 还有没有其他的想要教我？
你比如说圆戏，
啊，
我教你一个动作，提。
Like a monkey.
你看看这个动作提起来很简单。但是要去含胸，脖子收起来，腹部收起来，对心脏形成一个左右上下的挤压，对，好，然后放松，很简单，对吧？哎，给它提起来，放松。那我们模仿猿猴的动作啊，使自己精神上也可以放松，收。可以和呼吸配合起来，提起来，吸气。
Okay, so this is like a monkey.
这样就和气功结合起来。
Okay, thank you very much. So, this is like a. Okay, this is like a monkey, and actually, your heart is squeezing from all sides. So, what is the benefit of this kind of movement?
这个很圆的这个动作对什么地方有？
对心脏啊。你看我们心脏在这里，我现在左右给它挤压，脖子一收上面挤压，腹部一收下面挤压，形成一个挤压，对心脏的挤压放松的动作。
So this is actually the movements we're just doing are actually helpful for our heart. 您能不能再给我们教一个动作？因为网友非常非常喜欢做这个。Can you tell us more about it?
比如说我们消化不良的时候，我们可以做一个模仿熊的动作。
熊的动作。
下面我们给它固定，然后腹部压下去，拉上来，朝左面，朝右面。
Okay, this is like a bear.
我们把这四个点给它连起来。
And it's good for our stomach.
好，手放在这里，好，给它连起来。这个就熊运对消化系统有作用。再换一个方向。也可以和呼吸配合起来，手起来的时候吸气。
Breathing in, and then when you go down, like breathing out. Thank you very much. So I will try to remember all the movements you taught me today. 我会努力地记着您教我的所有动作。And also, what about your guys in front of the screen? Do you get it? And do you remember all the movements and gestures? I hope you all enjoy our teaching section. Okay, so we have another comment from our dear audience. Wow, wonderful movement. And what about me? Do I make it right? I don't know, but I think it's very funny and very interesting. So now it's question time. 现在开始跟您问一些问题。I will ask one question first, and please feel free to ask questions if you have any, and we will try to ask the expert to answer some of your questions. The first question is...Is it really helpful, and in what way is it helpful to our body, to our health? 您觉得这个从
十二号背的位置，就是分七点九五分， 因为这个五禽戏是1800年以前中国一个很有名的医学家叫华佗，他开始编创的，所以他编创的时候一定是把健身和动作是结合起来的。那么我们现在改编以后，从中医的角度说来，我们五个戏对着人的五个脏器，肝心脾肺肾和五个动物是对应的。那么我们加了很多现代的理念，比如说脊柱的全方位蠕动，远端肢体的远端关节蠕动啊，呼吸和动作的完整的配合，我们这些因素都考虑的，这些因素对我们的身体都会很有帮助。
我先翻译一下。So our Master Yu told us that the one of the benefits for doing this kind of exercise is that as it is a very ancient and old form of exercise, as I have mentioned before, with the originator of Huatuo, it considers the mind and also the body as well. It's a combination of mind and body, and it's not only going to stretch your body, but also it's going to help you to get more peace in your mind. And also with the design of our dear Master Yu, this new version, the modern version of Wu Qin Xi or Five Animals Play, includes a lot of elements from the 21st century, such as the movements of the neck. And it is kind of a really new thing for the modern people, because in a kind of age like this, in the modern age, we tend to read a lot of things on our camera and with our phone. So this is really good for the 21st century people, and this is a combination actually of history as well as modern technology and modern phenomenon. So another question is that can you tell us the relationship between Wu Qin Xi and Chinese martial arts?
应该说武清戏和中国武术它都是中国传统文化的主要组成部分，但是它们是很有关系的。你大概武术上面知道象形拳吗？
知道。
对，有很多，比如说模仿猴子的有猴拳，模仿鸭子的有鸭形拳，还有模仿老虎和鸟有虎鹤双形，它们都是受到五禽戏的启发以后才变成的武术套路。只不过五禽戏它主要是朝健身养生方面发展，而武术呢，它是武术，它是具有攻防含义，啊，有所区别，但是有共同点。
So there are a lot of similarities between Wu Qin Xi and Chinese ancient martial arts. Actually, in Chinese martial arts, we also have a lot of imitating and mimicking gestures like of dogs or of monkeys. But Wu Qin Xi have more focus on health or on everyday life, but Chinese martial arts has more focus or emphasis on something else, like on the real skills of all those very shiny and fabulous skills. Okay, our okay, our dear audience who are watching our show before the screen, please now stand up and learn some movement yourself. Don't always sit there in front of the computer. It will do harm to your body. Can you explain a little bit about the movements they are doing right now? 能
不能简单解释一下这个目前正在做的动作？好，他们现在就开始做猿戏，模仿猿猴的动作。左顾右盼就是我刚才教你的这个动作，对吧？对心脏有好处，而且能够脚尖提起来，能够提好人的平衡能力。
What they are doing just now is the monkey movement we've just taught you, and yes, and they are watching, like looking right and then looking left, and as they get their toes up, they're standing on their toes. They will do more benefit to their balance as well.
这个动作叫猿摘，模仿猿猴摘果的动作，啊，他的手心变化很多。通过这个动作，我们怎么想办法把神经系统和我们肌肉的这联系给它加强，提高人的协调能力。
So So this movement is also from the monkey movements. And it's like a monkey getting the fruits from the trees. And they pay attention to their fingers, the gestures of their fingers. And it will help you to get more balanced of your whole body. So this is a kind of a holistic movement.
这个动作叫鸟伸，模仿鸟伸展肢体的动作，啊，把我们的胸腔给它打开，对呼吸系统很有帮助。
So this movement now, as we can see through our camera, is one of the bird movements. And you can see there, the participants are actually stretching their arms like a bird. They're like flying high up in the sky. And this will do good to your whole body, especially to your limbs. Like doing all the stretching up and down and then doing it again.Yes, and they also do good to your lungs as well, because you are now moving your arms up and down, and it will stretch your whole body and do good to your lungs and chest. Okay, so moving on. I have another question, is that...How did this kind of exercise pass on from one generation to another? 就是咱们这个是怎么传承的？像这个武器，
整个这个从两代到另外一代。应该最早的文献记载，华佗创编了五禽戏，啊，后来呢，在文字上他没留下了多少东西。我们在编创的时候呢，我们就把古代到今天所有的文字资料、影像资料全部进行了归纳整理。然后在继承传统的基础上加了很多科学健身的理念，就变成了现在这套五禽戏。
So actually, there are not a lot of documents left after Hua Tuo originally created this kind of exercise. But with the all the information gathered, the videos or the documents we have, and also to combine it with the modern technology and the modern movements of the 21st century, and this is how the modern version of 五禽戏 is now coming up.
So, we are now in the new version of 五禽戏. Now, in the world,
yes, so instead of having an inheritor here in China, actually the modern version of 五禽戏 or Five Animals Play decided to do it like more in public, like everyone could learn it, and that's the way that we pass on from one generation to another. And one more question, in your own opinion, will the Westerners accept this kind of practice? Because as we know, the most well-known active type of Kung Fu is Tai Chi Quan, and the most passive one is meditation.
肯，我们在国外推广，整个气功里面最受欢迎的就是五禽戏，因为它，接近了我们人和动物之间的联系，符合生态，啊，符合天人合一的这种理念，而且在编创的时候考虑到很多健身因素，健身效果也非常好，也很有趣，所以大家很愿意学。
So actually, our dear Master Yu here have provided us with the information that is 五禽戏 or Five Animals Play is actually the most famous or most well-accepted kind of Qigong in Western world abroad, because it combines the animals with the humans' movement. So it is very interesting, and I think...Yes, and that's the truth. And also we got some comments, interesting comments from our audience. Well, nice and enjoying. Okay, also we have another interesting question from our dear audience. How is the food over there? Okay, so here we have a lot of different kinds of food in Zibo, and Chinese food, as we all know, are always delicious. We have so many different kinds of vegetables and meats.So, please, if you are interested in the Zibo in Shandong app, you can just come here to take a look yourself and try some of the delicious food. The Chinese delicious foods are always good. 好，非常非常谢谢你。
不客气。 现在在表演的就是五清戏的故居来的安徽的，啊，华佗就是这里的人，所以他们五清戏开展得很好。
Yes, so following our camera on the left side on stage, actually they are from Anhui province, and Anhui, as we know, are the hometown of Huatuo. So the team is from Anhui. We can say that they will do it really good because they are the predecessor of, they are the descendants of Huatuo.
好，谢谢。
Thanks again for our dear Master Yu for teaching us and also for doing the interview. And so we can see on the stage they're doing this kind of movements or like. And they're lifting their legs up.And actually requires a lot of balance. Some of the movements seem to be quite easy to do, but actually if you do it by yourself, you will find out that it's really hard. Especially those with the, if you want to stand on one foot. You have to keep the balance. Thank you guys for following our live broadcasting on this very old form of exercise. And I hope you all enjoy the show. And if you are interested in it, you can, you know, there are some of the masters there abroad who are teaching Wu Qingxi or Five Animals Play Qigong and also other kinds of Qigong. You can try to learn it yourself. And also if you are interested in Chinese culture, you can come over here to China to give it a try yourself. And also as our audience just asked about the Chinese food, perhaps it's better to come here to visit China, to Zibo in Shandong province to taste the delicious food here. And now we are approaching the end of our live broadcasting for today. I hope you all enjoy a good time with us here in Zibo. So how do you feel about Wu Qingxi or about Five Animals Play Qigong or about other kinds of Qigong or also about Chinese culture? Do you like it? Do you want to learn it? Well, if you are interested in today's topic, please tell us in comments and share the video.And thanks again for staying with us the whole time. And we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.